The impact of cancer treatment on fertility in women is not the same for everyone and is sometimes difficult to predict. Women are born with all the eggs they will ever have, so chemotherapy and radiation therapy can reduce the number of eggs available for fertility. This video explains two options for fertility preservation: egg and embryo freezing. Both processes involve collecting eggs from a woman's ovaries and preserving them for future use. The eggs can either be frozen unfertilised or fertilised by sperm and frozen as embryos. Either approach has similar chance of pregnancy, but embryo freezing is only an option if a woman has a male partner. It's also important to remember that embryos are a biological product, so legally belong to both people. Collecting eggs involves stimulating the ovaries in line with the female menstrual cycle. Several different injections are required: a follicle-stimulating hormone to grow eggs, a medication to prevent premature ovulation, and an injection to trigger the final egg maturation step. The process also involves ultrasounds, usually transvaginal, and an egg collection procedure, which is done under sedation. Because it takes about 2 weeks to mature eggs for collection, egg or embryo freezing are time critical and preferably need to be undertaken before cancer treatments. This means that this option may not be suitable for some women. For women undertaking egg collection, the risk of complications is low. They may include medication side effects, risks of surgical procedure and anesthesia, nausea, mild abdominal pain, bloating, and the specific risks of no eggs or too many eggs in a condition called ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, where over-response can lead to swelling of the ovaries and fluid leak in the body. While cancer and cancer treatment can affect fertility, the benefits of egg and embryo freezing allow for the chance of future biological pregnancy. For further general information about this topic, see the links in the description box. For information specific to your situation, please contact your trusted GP or healthcare provider, or call Cancer Council on 13 11 20 to speak with a cancer nurse.